Hey, what's up YouTube? Leo Shang here, host of the Extreme Philly Fishing channel. Today is March 26, 2017. I'm down here on the Schuylkill River in Center City, Philadelphia. My 27th outing of this year, okay? And folks, check this out, huh? What a beautiful view we got here of the river, huh? Yeah, it is a spring. 45 degrees Fahrenheit, all right? Yeah, so yeah, guys, it is a little bit chilly, but I decided to come down here to the river with one objective in mind, one goal in mind, right? And today, we're going to try to find out if the white perch, the Morone americana, are already swimming up the river or not. For those who are local and watch my channel, you guys probably know about this already, but I just wanted to emphasize on this topic. Comes the spring of every year, there are a few migrations on the Delaware in the Schuylkill River that some people are aware of and some others are not so aware of, okay? As I like to tell people, there are three migrations that are not too well known. One is the geezer shad, the Dorosoma cepedianum. They can't really be caught by hook, so a lot of people don't pay attention to them. The second one, right, is the white sucker. They actually swim up the Delaware and the Schuylkill River for spawning season. That is the Catostomus commersoni. Usually, it is a bycatch. Nobody really targets the white sucker, you know? And the third one is the white perch, the Morone americana. That is actually the fish that has a little bit of food value, but most importantly, it serves really well to us anglers as bait, you know? And then after that, you have the three migrations that everyone, you know, is pretty much familiar with, right? I'm talking about the striped bass, the Morone saxatilis, the American shad, right? The Alosa sapidissima, and the hickory shad, the Alosa mediocris. And I mean, I don't know if you guys notice or not, but year after year, the weather gets a little bit weirder and weirder, you know? So this year, the weather has been pretty odd. Water temperatures have been odd. So this year, I have not been able yet to determine if these migrations have started or not. And my starting point is always the white perch. So today I'm here on the river, we're gonna try to catch some white perch, and if we do so, if we see that the white perch are running the Schuylkill River right now, end of March, we know that everything else is coming very, very soon. So stay tuned, I'm gonna set up three rods here and we will see what will happen. Well, easy, we got a bite here, but that is definitely not a perch. That seems like a catfish. First fish of the day coming up right here. Fellas, I was setting up my second rod on the nightcrawler. Little catfish decided to hitch. But this is not the species that we are looking for today, that's for sure. And I mean, people often ask me, you know, Leo, how do you know it is a catfish, right? Well, the catfish bite is very, very different than the white perch bite. So, you know, as soon as you see it, you're usually able to identify it. Check that out, little channel catch, first fish of the day. All right, this one, we don't even need the net. It's pretty small, you know? So we just swing it up here, boom. Well, it is a species, right? I mean, we can't hate on the little guy, but definitely not what we are looking for. Check this out, hitch on the second hook above. That's why they are known as bottom rovers, right? And not bottom feeders. Let me take a photo and release this guy. Well, 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 final view of our first fish of the day, little channel catfish, Ictalurus punctatus. At least we know that something is biting in 45 degrees Fahrenheit water temperature, right? It gave us a little bit of hope. All right, fellas, so I just got done setting up my three rods. As you guys can see, I got a medium light, a medium heavy, and a heavy rod. And of course, I'm rocking all my Cast King grills down here today. On my medium light, I got my Cast King Sharky 2 right here with 6 pounds fluorocarbon. Over here, I got my Cast King Mela 3000 on 12 pounds fluorocarbon. On this third rod right now, I'm kind of fishing for bait, you know, because if I catch anything small, I'm gonna live line on this one. So I'm kind of using my Cast King Kodiak 4000 with 20 pounds test line. And if I do get to live line something today, it's gonna have 30 pounds Cast King fluorocarbon leader. So let's do this. So far, you know, we just got that one catfish. I'm putting my hopes that there will be some white perch swimming around here later today. We will see. Stay tuned, fellas. Got a bite on that last rod right there. Line went real slack, man. Real slack. That was the fish on. Ooh, I felt a bite here. Oh yeah, fish on. Oh man, looks decent too. But again, not a white perch. It's a channel cat. Oh man. And I don't know if you guys noticed or not. Oh, maybe I didn't show in the video. I actually cast this rod right over there, you know, at the bridge piling. I was hoping to catch a little eel as bait. There we go, second fish of the day, not even worth the net. There we go, little 1.5 pounder, 2 pounder. Little catfish, greedy fish for sure, man. Oh boy. Well, at least, you know, the catfish are willing to bite and entertain us a little bit today. 1.5 pounder right here. But I'm still looking for that white perch bite here so I can actually live line something out there for the bigger species, so we'll see. Second fish of the day! The size is increasing, but it's still not what we're looking for. Man, these police have no respect for my fishing lines, man. Are you serious, bro? Oh, man, you can't say anything back, you know, because, man, you don't want to make them mad. What the heck? Oh, we got a bite right here. Line went slack. Seems to be another catfish. Oh, man, I don't know about the perch, but the catfish are definitely pretty active today. Let's see. Oh yeah, it's on. Feels small though, feels really small. In the range of 1.5, 2 pounds. This is actually my new rod, you know, my new St. Croix from the Avid collection. I got a medium heavy this time for my bass fishing. Haha, look at the size of that little creature, man. How greedy is that, man? I mean, if I'm gonna land some catfish, right? At least give me some giants, right? Look at this. Oh my god. All right, well, at least it is something, right? Boom. Oh man, and there goes another one. So, quick update, fellas. I've been here for about 35 minutes now on 343, all channel catfish. I mean, it's not really what we're looking for, but I can't really complain, right? Catching 3-channel catfish is still catching better. You know, it's still better than catching nothing, right? So I still got my rods here in the water. We are waiting for some white perch so I can live line some fish on my rods, you know? And as you guys can see, the tide is going up. Check this out, huh? Water is starting to get into this little spot right here. You know, high tide is only about 1.5 hour away. So one would think that with the tide coming in, the perch would come in too, right? If they are migrating up the river. So I'm still having hopes that we're gonna catch something a little bit different, you know. I mean, we'll see, you know. Hopefully it doesn't turn out to be just a catfish day. Stay tuned. Look at that. We got a little tap again right over there. Come on, if you're gonna play with my worm, at least inhale it, right? That's how I like it. Get it? Oh no, he gave up, man. What is wrong with this fish? I hate this fish that keep playing with my worm and they just don't swallow it, man. This is nuts. At least get it nicely. And oh man, they go and just nibble right there on the tip of the worm, you know what I'm saying, man? Ah, son. Whoa. Got a bite here. It's just taking it, man. Taking it like a champ. Ah, oh, wait a moment. This one may be a little bit bigger. I'm actually feeling some weight to it. Oh yeah, you know what? This may be a decent catfish, folks. This may be a decent catfish. I'm feeling it. This is no 1.5 pounder. This may be three pounds, something like that, you know? Which is, of course, better than nothing, right? So let me take my time with this guy here, you know? Bit on a small piece of nightcrawler, man. This is pretty nuts. Take my time here. It's gonna surface soon. The take was not bad too. Man, I just hope this is not another 1.5 pounder that just got tangled on the line, you know? Hope this feels a little bit better. Come on, come here. Yeah, I would say 3 pounds, something like that. Hopefully. It's feeling pretty good on the Cast King Sharky too. Folks always ask me for recommendations. Oh yeah, look at that. Yeah, that's about 3 pounds. That's a good estimate that I gave right there. We're gonna measure this fish. But that's about 3 pounds. That's a nice fish. For this river, that's a nice fish any day. But let's walk in. Gotta walk into the side so I don't need to use my net. Boom, check that out, huh? Bottom hook too. Amazing. Come here. Sorry?
They always come that big out of this
school. Nah, I mean, this is an average size. Yeah, this is an average size. Nice. Boom! Check this out, huh?
Small river where we all had his campus.
Yeah. Oh yeah, good stuff. Alright guys, we're gonna get a measure on this one. This one's a little bit bigger. I may have underestimated it, saying 3 pounds, but this is in the range of 3 to 4 pounds right here. Only a small piece of nightcrawler. We gotta do a quick weight through the gill, okay? I don't usually like measuring through the gill, but it's all right. This one's gonna be fine. So there you go, my estimate was 3 pounds. This is actually four and a half. All right, decent. Decent catfish right here. Let's take a shot. Oh, we gotta release this guy. Alright guys, I took a few shots of the catfish right here, 4.5 pounder. Let's put it back where it belongs. Boom! Nice catfish for a little piece of nightcrawler, you know? Easy, big boy, is that way, okay? Let me help you out a little bit. That way. My man. This is one odd catfish. It's that way. Ah, little push. You see that, what it does? Yeah, he got it. Boom, he goes back. Still no white perch though. Oh, what's going on? Is everything all right? Excuse me, is everything okay? Oh, you're gonna land the fish over here. Well, you could have said something, you know what I'm saying? Yeah, you know, instead of going through my lines and everything, I would have appreciated that. What in the world, man? You're kidding me? I don't know what's wrong with people nowadays, man. You know, that's what I always tell people. You gotta have some etiquette, man. At least say, excuse me, you know, let me pass. Like, what the hell, man? I mean, I'm happy he caught a fish and stuff, but passing my rods like that, you know, that's not nice. What's up? Yeah, you know, next time, just say, excuse me, right? And then everything's okay. Okay? Alright, alright. So yeah, you guys just saw that, huh? If there's one thing that I really, really hate when it comes to fishing, when I am fishing out here, is people touching my stuff without my permission, you know? It doesn't take a lot, seriously, you know, to just come around and say, hey, excuse me, or can I pass, right? And stuff like that. So this kind of stuff drives me nuts, you know? So if you're watching this video, kids and adults alike, you know, just make sure you have the proper etiquette, you know, the proper manners. Come by, if you need to pass, you know, just say, excuse me, you know? Language barrier is not an excuse, okay? If you don't know how to speak or whatever, man, you could at least do a little gesture, you know, to say, hey, I need to pass. You know what I'm saying? So yeah, man, I get a little bit mad about things like this, you know? I don't go around touching other people's stuff, right, that doesn't belong to me. So I would, of course, expect people to do the same for me. But anyways, right, just a quick update. The tide is still coming up. We have caught some nice fish today, including a 4.5-pounder. Sadly, our target fish, you know, is not here yet. So I'm gonna give it a few more hours. I will see if I can land anything else, and then we're gonna call it a day. Stay tuned. All right, guys, it is about 2 o'clock right now. The action really died down afternoon. I got with me here, Cripper Kid, and my brother-in-law right there. They actually decided to join me for a little bit. I'm gonna maybe include some footage after this of my brother-in-law catching a nice channel catfish. But anyways, you know, today was a pretty interesting day for sure, huh? A lot of things happened. I ended up catching some fish, but I really caught everything but my target, right? Which was the white perch. But you know, at the end of the day, this river still gives me a good feel of what is going on right now. Especially because I know that in the Delaware River, the white perch are biting really good. So they are just not here yet. I gotta tell you guys, give it 10 days to 2 weeks, 10 to 14 days, the white perch are going to be here in this river together with the striped bass. I'm not gonna say anymore, I'm not gonna give any spoilers because of course, I wanna be one of the first ones to come here and catch some nice fish, you know? So anyways guys, thank you very much for watching today's video. Hope it wasn't too boring. Tie lines and until next time.
朋友们，我跟你们讲一讲心里面的话，OK？我们现在不是在中国，我们是在国外，是不是？我们在国外，我们应该对别人好一点。不会讲英文那是两码事儿。你需要过的时候，不会讲，指一指嘛，指一指也好，是不是？人家的东西，你为什么要去动呢？是不是？ 不是你的你就别去动，别叫国外，别叫人家在国外觉得我们东方人没有教养，是不是？千万别给我们东方人在国外丢脸，这是一个非常重要的事情。OK，我也不多讲了。That's it. This is the message. All right. Okay, ooh, my man, what the heck is this? Don't tell me one of my subs decided to send me some good fine grade cocaine here, right? Other than the fact that this is, instead of white, this is brown, and it has some glitter in it, man. What, oh, Cyrus, what's going on here, huh, man? What kind of drugs you send me here, huh?